If an appellate court reaches a decision, the court may, for whatever reason, decide that it does or does not want to accept the appeal, so that's completely up to the Supreme Court.
Now, a lot of people look at the appointments by the Trump administration, and you hear all the talk of, oh, the Supreme Court is set to overturn Roe, is lined up for that. But am I not correct that Supreme Court justices in general tend to think long and hard and are often very resistant to messing with precedent?
That's very true. And there's a couple of things that I think are incorrect prognostications that we're hearing right now, particularly in the open media. And that's, first of all, an assumption that the Supreme Court wants to overturn Roe v. Wade. I don't know that that's a safe assumption. If you look at some of the decisions that have come down from the Supreme Court this term, Justice Gorsuch and Justice Kavanaugh both have sided with the so-called liberals on several decisions. So to say that they're guaranteed votes to overturn Roe v. Wade just because President Trump nominated them, I think is false. We can't make those assumptions. Secondly, if the court does want to overturn Roe v. Wade, if you look at the way that the Missouri bill and certainly the bill out of Louisiana and the bill out of Alabama, those bills are basically either heartbeat bills or 8 weeks after heartbeat or 8 weeks after conception bills. And it may be that the justices on the Supreme Court, those who want to place severe restrictions on Roe v. Wade, would feel uncomfortable saying that those bills, those laws, particularly the Missouri, Alabama, and Louisiana laws, they may not want to deal with those laws because they go too far. So it may be that the court simply says, we're not going to review those at this time until a different law comes up in front of us. So there are lots of options here. And to say that there's one clear path that the Supreme Court is going to follow at this point, it's just way too early to make that prediction.
And people right now need to understand that it's status quo. If somebody shows up at an abortion clinic or somebody is having these kinds of conversations, nothing has changed even with this law being signed at this point from a practical standpoint.
That's correct, because as soon as this law is it was signed yesterday, but being long before it's going to take effect at the end of August, there will be a federal judge somewhere that will hold that that law is unconstitutional and will prohibit the law from being enforced. So it will be status quo in Missouri, or certainly in these other states, like I mentioned, of Louisiana and Alabama and others. It will be status quo until the appellate process ends.
Has it surprised you at all that somebody in one of these states, rather than going for the touchdown in their eyes, so to speak, you know, going for the really, really restrictive law, that they haven't gone for that more moderate law that they might be able to get through the Supreme Court, that seems more realistic to get past the Supreme Court?
It does, to me, in fact. I would have thought that the better route, if a person was wanting to challenge or a state would want to challenge Roe versus Wade, it seems like you would go and continue the process that's been going on literally for the last 20 years, which has continued to chip away at it. But this is really going, you mentioned touchdown, and that's exactly what these laws are designed to do, is to go straight for the touchdown. And I think that tactic has some disadvantages if one is from the perspective of trying to challenge Roe versus Wade. The other thing too, George, that I want to mention is this. There's a very common misperception in the public that if Roe versus Wade is overturned, that means abortion is illegal nationwide. That is false. Roe versus Wade simply stated that it was a federal issue, not a state issue. So if Roe versus Wade is overturned through either the Missouri law or some of these other laws, what would happen is it would go back to the states. So states individually could determine for themselves whether abortion would be legal or would be illegal. And it's not as if Roe versus Wade is overturned that abortion is illegal nationwide. That is a myth, and that's simply not what would happen.
Yeah, but we're probably a long way from that. A lot of court battles to be fought as of yet, and should be an interesting thing to observe, I would think.
Absolutely. It's going to be fascinating to watch.
All right. Well, Brad Young, once again from Harris, Dowell, Fisher, and Young, our KMOX legal analyst, thank you for joining us this morning.
My pleasure.
Saturdays in May, win up to $3,000 in Royal Free Play and a new Jeep Wrangler playing American Dreams. Grand finale Friday, May 31st at 10 p.m. Only at Casino Queen. A better gamble. See club for details. Must be 21. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER.
Planning to sell your home? Call Gloria Liu with GL International Realty at Coldwell Banker Premier Group. This is Debbie Monterey, and putting the most money in your pocket is the number one reason why you should call Gloria Liu. Gloria Liu will guarantee to sell your home at your agreed to upfront price, or she'll buy it herself. Guaranteed in writing. And Gloria's results are incredible. Gloria Liu sold Vishal's home after he previously had listed it with another agent and was completely frustrated. He called Gloria and she delivered, selling his home in just 2 days at 100% of the listing price. Take it from Vishal and call the agent with the buyers. Thousands of ready buyers who have raised their hand looking to buy a home right now. Call Gloria Liu at 314-325-6888. That's 314-325-6888. Or online at GloriaHasTheBuyers.com. That's Gloria Liu of GL International Realty, GloriaHasTheBuyers.com. And start packing.
Is your roof full of ugly algae black stains? Just one roof restore treatment.